That's very good. It also is super stable. Try and rock it.
This is an E8 robot built by students. They're given sort of basic frame parts, they're given motors, but they take that and they do whatever experiment they want.
Not 1A, we can take 3A and
4A. Wait, so I'm gonna plug that back in.
So our aim is to have the robot dive and take data at a certain point, so right now we're testing that the GPS is actually is moving the motors in such a way that it would eventually end up generally in the direction of that point.
We're planning on analyzing currents in the ocean by autonomously navigating our robot to a waypoint and then letting the waves carry it for a specific amount of time. And then we will look at the difference between the initial GPS point and the final GPS point to create a vector of like how strong the current was and what direction it was moving in.
Good job, team.
You see outside here is a couple students, and one of them just launched her robot out there, and they're testing whether it's autonomously going to track to different spots in the lake. Once it gets there, it can take whatever measurement that they programmed it to take.
I chose to be an engineer because I really like building things, and I feel like we're really challenged and we're able to like apply the things that we learn in class like actually in the workplace, and like it feels like it's actually real.
I felt like this class has taught me a lot of stuff that you just simply can't learn in the classroom environment, mostly like debugging skills and like learning how to figure things out without either a textbook or a professor to help you. Like it's something that you have to like take responsibility for the work that you're doing, and I've really enjoyed that experience.
It's supposed to go 30 meters out plus or minus 6 meters.
Yeah,
come back!
Come back!
Come back!
Whoa. Good days are ahead.